Can you spot the difference? How about now? Hi everyone, it's Smitha. Today I'm going to be showing you how you can enhance your features and change your face structure using contouring and bronzing. And I'm also going to be talking about the difference between the two. So if you're ready, let's begin. If you observe your face, there's a lot of dimension to it. You'll see shadows, you'll see some areas that are deeper, you'll see highlights, you'll also see acne scars, spots, hyperpigmentation, so it's not just one flat color. Now, these dimensions in your face build the structure of your face. But obviously, there's a few things that we want to keep on the face and a few things we want to conceal, like the acne scars and the hyperpigmentation. And that's why we end up using a foundation. So let's go ahead and create that clean canvas. I'm going to start with the Prime Plus Primer. This is from Revlon. I'm just giving myself a good massage all over the face before I apply a foundation. And for foundation, I'm going to be using the CoverGirl Outlast All Day Stay Fabulous Foundation. And for reference, I'm going to be linking all the products that I'm using today in the description box right below this video, so do check that out. Once we've created that clean canvas is when we can actually talk about bronzing and contouring, because these are the two elements that actually bring back the structure and dimension to the face. And for concealer around the eyes and mouth and in areas where I have those dark patches and spots, I'm going to be using the CoverGirl True Blend Undercover Concealer. I've also listed all the shades in the description box below. Using the Airspun Translucent Powder, I'm going to set my entire face. Let's look at the before face again. And if you observe carefully, there's areas on the face where there's shadows. Now, these dimensions in your face build the structure of your face. So one way to bring back the dimension on the face on this clean canvas is to use a contour. Think of contour to imitate a shadow. A couple key features about shadows is one, they have a cooler undertone, like a gray color. And second, they're usually matte. They don't have a shine to them. So contours usually have these two features. They're usually cooler or have a cooler undertone, and they're usually matte. Now, if you have a warmer skin or warmer undertone, you can also get away by using a contour that has a warmer shade, but it's not going to look as natural as using something closer to a gray shade. I'll go ahead and use the contour on my right side so we can compare it with the left side. Because it imitates a shadow, I'm going to use it in areas where the shadows are naturally casted on my face to enhance my features, starting with the hollows of my cheekbones. I'm going to add a little bit and slowly build it up, and even with just a tad bit, you can see how much of a difference it makes. So I'm going around in areas where there's shadow naturally casted on my face, and I'm just enhancing it with the contour. That includes the hollows of my cheekbones, my jawline, as well as my nose. So here's the right side with the contour, and here's the left side. You can see how much of a difference it makes in adding a structure to your face. As you can see, when I look straight, the left side is looking rounder than the right side because the right side has those dimensions. I'm going to finish up on the left side as well. That we've created those shadows, it's brought back the structure into the face. It has enhanced the features like the nose and the jawline, and overall it's given more dimension. You can also use it on your body, like to enhance your collarbones, basically any place where a shadow is casted. Again, let's go back to the before picture. Other than the shadows itself, you'll also see other dimension, like a sun-kissed glow because you have that tan on your face. So that's where a bronzer comes into place. Bronzers, unlike contours, don't have a cool undertone. In fact, they have a warmer, more orangish undertone because they have to imitate that sun-kissed warm glow. They bring back warmth into your face. And bronzers are used in areas where you want to create that warm glow on your face, or you naturally have a tan on your face and you want to enhance it. And for me, it's usually above my contour, just below my cheekbones, on the sides, on my temples, as well as my forehead. And as you can see, it's brought back so much warmth into your face. Now, if you already have a lot of warm in your face, you can totally skip the bronzer and just stick with the contour. Again, here's a comparison. Contours usually have a cooler undertone, while bronzers have a warmer undertone. Contours imitate a shadow, giving your face structure and dimension, while bronzers imitate a beautiful sun-kissed glow to give your face a warm tan. Contours are usually matte, while bronzers usually have a light sheen or a shine to them. But that is not necessarily true for all bronzers. You also get matte bronzers, like one of my favorite, which is the Hoola Bronzer by Benefit Cosmetics. And for that reason, bronzers and contours can also be used interchangeably. If you have a warmer undertone, you can get away by using a matte bronzer to contour your face. And if you find a contour that has a warmer tone or undertone, you can most definitely use it as a matte bronzer. I finished the rest of the face and here is the completed look. Let's compare the before and after. As you can see, while we've maintained the shadows and the dimensions in the after, we also have a cleaner skin tone because of the foundation. And let's also compare the one with just foundation and the after. With the foundation only, you can see it's a flatter surface, it's a clean canvas without any dimensions. But in the after, there's so much more dimension. So next time you want that chiseled jawline or a nice bone structure to your face, go with a contour. And when you want that sun-kissed, beautiful tan and warmth to your face, go with a bronzer. I hope this answered all your questions and I hope that was easy enough. Let me know if you enjoyed this video by commenting below. And if you enjoyed it, please don't forget to thumbs up. And if you're new here, please consider subscribing. I post several times a week. I love you guys so much and I will see you soon with a brand new one. Bye guys.